So, day, what is this? I know, I'm just figuring out when this started. I think it's day 27 of Neil Gaiman held hostage. And we're now actually at the point, the beginning of these things. People say to me, does your hand hurt? I bet your hand hurts. And I say, no, it's fine. Brain goes, what do you call it? And we've actually hit, the last couple of days, we've hit the point where I have to start icing the hand. When people say, I bet your hand hurts. I say, yeah. So, we're here. But brain's still more or less functioning, and still enjoying being on the road and talking to people, which will go on until Saturday. And then I get kind of a magical break for about 3 or 4 days. And then that sort of, and I do San Diego, and I get a week off with my wife, which I'm very much looking forward to. Thank you. And then I go to England, and then it all finishes in Scotland at the end of the month being August. And I'm done. And people have been asking, is this really the last signing tour, or is this just something you said to make us come? Like Cher or Frank Sinatra. No, this is quite genuinely the last signing tour. It's not the last time I will ever tour. I'm quite sure that there will come times in the future when I will I'll turn up places and I may do reading tours, we may do more evenings with Neil and Amanda, maybe all sorts of things. But the sheer this is the smallest hall that I'm at on this whole tour. To put that into context. Ann Arbor 2 nights ago was 1,700 people. And we finished at 3 o'clock in the morning. And it wasn't much fun for anybody in the last couple of hours. And, you know, the reason why there are 800 people and the reason why the tickets to this sold out the first week is we did somewhere doing it which has 800 people, and if we've been somewhere that held 2,000 people, I'd be signing for 2,000 people tonight. And it doesn't really work. But I love you a lot, and I like talking to you. Thank you. And, you know, I really like it, and I like getting out, and I like reading in front of people, and I like answering questions, and I actually like meeting people. It's just the icing the arm. So, as far as I'm concerned, last ever signing tour of America, but you will see me again. I'm not, like, vanishing mysteriously to fight crime. Because I missed her. She was in Australia made me a record, and I had gone to Florida, because it was January. And it's cold in these parts. And I have some friends who have more houses than they have bodies. And I borrowed a house in Florida. And I went off, and I was meant to be working on, actually on Doctor Who, on Nightmare in Silver. You don't have to whoop every time Doctor Who's mentioned it. But I got off to write it, I got off to write some other things. And I was writing them, but I was also missing my wife a lot. And she was very busy making an album. And we'd been, you know, conducting a relationship for the previous 4 years, and sometimes it was long distance and sometimes it wasn't, but you know, whenever it was long distance, she'd call, or I'd call her, check in, we'd write on emails, and suddenly I was in a world in which I'd get texts every day or two saying, hi, all good here, making out, love you. And I'd go, I miss you. And she'd go, yeah, I'm making out. And I thought, I know what I would do, I will write her a story that she'll like. And I'll send it from here, and she'll be happy. Because if you get a story from me that's just written just for you, obviously, you'll be happy if I put stuff in it. That was my theory. And I thought, as long as it's got stuff in that is big sort of, you know, you'll like this stuff. And she doesn't like fantasy very much. But she likes me. So I thought, well, it'll have me in. And she likes honesty. She likes feelings. Which I think is something to do with her being neither English nor male. But I thought, good, I will put all of those things, and I will set it, you know, in the place that I lived when I was a boy, and I'll make a protagonist who's pretty much me when I was 7. Look out through my eyes. And I'll send her my short story. And then I started writing it. And it kept going. And it kept going. And it kept going. And after a while, I thought, it's not a short story, it's a novelette. And I thought, well, okay. Not a novelette, it's a novella. Short novella. And then, somewhere in there, I wrote an email to my editor saying, I seem to be writing a longish novella, I'm not sure what we'll do with it. And I went back to writing. And then I got to the end of the book, and I typed it all up, as it had been written in handwriting. And once it was all typed up, I did a word count. I sent a really surprised email. I'm kind of apologetic to my editor saying, I appear to have written a novel.